Hello, poker fans. I'm your executive director, Kirk Fowle, and I want to welcome you to Windy City Poker Championship. On our last show, we kicked off a qualifier to send one lucky player to the 2019 World Series of Poker main event in Las Vegas. The roller coaster action saw half of our table eliminated with David Jackson, Luis Martinez, Daryl Terrell, Kevin Pendergrast, and our sponsor, Joel Schaub, hitting the rail. Joel plans on joining Jason and Ben in the booth for commentary. But before we get to the action, let's take a look at the chip counts for our remaining players.
All right, so we will have our 1,000 chip ante back on the button this hand.
One on the button. You got it. No, stop yelling at me. Are we fighting? Is this our first fight? I don't want to do this. Not on TV. Not on TV.
Players getting a little bit giddy. They lasted longer than I did, though.
Angelo's got the ace 8 off, and he's debating a raise or possibly an all-in. It looks like he's putting 19. Them all in.
Didn't debate for too long. He's putting them in there. 19.
I wish you had less.
And I think Ed's going to let out a big sigh when Andrew either calls or raises. Tim's going to throw his dime store away. And the cards are on their backs. Pocket nines for Andrew versus an ace eight for Angelo. Jack 6-6 doesn't really change anything. The five of clubs on the turn. And with the six on the river, Andrew's full house is good. And Angelo finishes in fifth place.
We have a special treat here. Joining us in the booth, Windy City Poker Championship friend, supporter, Mr. Joel Schaub. Welcome to the booth.
Gentlemen, it's really good to be here.
We were hoping we were going to be interviewing you at the end of it all.
That's right. Well, it's good to be here and actually just talk about all the players that were really good at the table tonight.
We've been talking about sort of the players and the player styles today and how some of them have I'm on camera. How their graphs have gone up and down if you were to chart their chips. And Craig's has been all over the place. He's been on a real roller coaster. You played a little bit different style than you usually do. A little looser early on, but
I played tight because a lot of times when you're actually facing some of these players and it's only no rebuys, you have to actually sit there and make sure there's times that you just don't want to get your chips in unless you're good. And here we got Craig again coming in with a hand. You know he's going to be pushing some chips in here.
And we should see some action. Folded to Craig in the small blind.
Blind versus blind. Ed's definitely calling. All in. Oh, Ed goes all in.
He's all in right away.
Call.
And Craig instantly calls.
I'm prepared. It's not a great one.
He's been doing this quite a bit tonight. I've seen Craig actually push in a couple of times where I wasn't expecting him to. And here we are. Four-handed left, and he's still in. So let's see if he can survive this coin flip here.
He's a slight disadvantage. If he wins this one, he's got almost 60,000 in chips.
He flops a gut shot.
That's the wrong pain card, but he does have a gut shot draw. He's a king, hearts. A jack, or a 10.
Hearts, yeah, gets he's still the 10. Smiling, and there he
has
is.
Has to dodge a heart, dodges the heart. Picks up another 30,000 in chips.
And he knocks Ed down to 33,000 while Craig moves up to 57.
It's good to be Craig Casino.
Oh, well. Nice hand.
Small blind's 1,500, big blind 3,000, and our ante is paid by one player on the button. And it's 1,500 in this case. Craig Casino paid that tab. And Tim, who's been playing all day, first all right. act.
And two short stacks. We might get a big pot here because Craig may come all in right behind Tim.
It's the right spot for it. Tim actually has Craig covered.
Although Craig does have the better hand.
I got a fold.
Got a fold. Andrew's got the best hand, I would say.
I wonder. Really? Let's see.
What do you think he's gonna do?
Wow.
Let's take a look at it here.
That is just crazy.
Oh my gosh, you're telling me I could.
And so, assuming those aces hold up,
two kings.
We'll have a double elimination with Craig going on fourth and Tim taking that third place prize. But this is poker.
Two kings. Easy game in this seat. Jeez, like.
One. Nice. That's what's
wow.
up.
Wow. This game, Tim has flopped the joint.
A heart or a king.
And another heart on the turn. Or a king would give the aces the thing. Unbelievable. Andrew cannot figure out how to get his hand to hold up today.
Oh. He's out. You're in third.
And our other direct buy, direct entry, Craig Cassino, another just excellent poker player and friend of the show, has been eliminated in fourth place. I got to see the graph of Craig's chips. He was all over the map today, up and down. Such a talented player. Such a nice guy. One of the gentlemen of the game. And let's see if we can get Joel back on the machines, work on the lower body on this break.
Otherwise, we'll leave him on his microphone. He can sing to you while we're on break.
Guys, looks like we got a hand here. Ed's got pocket nines.
Tim makes a raise with the king 10 on the button. And Andrew with the suited ace.
Yeah, Ed's getting it all in. His last 27,000 with pocket nines.
And for only 19,000 more, I think Tim calls. I don't know what Andrew's got. Oh, Andrew already threw it away. But for 19,000 more, Tim's going to have a hard time folding this.
Unfortunately, at this point, you know, it represents almost a quarter of a stack, but there's already 40,000 in there. He's getting 2-1 on his money.
Yeah.
Ben's right. He does make the call.
Oh.
He's got two over cards.
You know?
It's the correct call. If the cards were on their backs, you make that call every time with the money that's already in there.
So Ed all in for his tournament life. Once again, we've seen him survive a couple of these. 7-5 deuce, all under cards. A queen is an over card, but a clean one. And a four of hearts on the river.
Ed's going to double up to 58,500.
And we're going to be on a break, but we've got a race here. We started the day with 10 players at this qualifier table, and now we are down to our final three. All three of these players are going to go home with a little bit of something, but everybody wants to win the first place prize, a $10,000 seat to the main event of the World Series of Poker, and some spending cash. I'm Jason Finn with Ben Ponzio and Joel Schaub. Don't go away. Windy City Poker Championship. We'll be right back.
Windy City Poker Championship t-shirts provided to players and crew by Nick Snacks Activewear. Quality silk screening, embroidery, and custom lettering. They're located in Homewood, Illinois. You can call them today at 708-799-0240. 708-799-0240. That's Nick Snacks.
And Ed is first to act this hand. If he plays this hand, it will probably be an all-in based on his stack size, 10 big blinds. We don't know what his cards are. They didn't make it into the square.
This is always fun. We get to sit here and take a guess and see.
I find it a lot easier when I can see their whole cards, Joel.
And he went all in, and it looks like Tim's got a hand to call him with.
I called.
He's not excited about it. He'll have 19,000 chips.
It's not that good. It's not that good, he said.
Guess we're going to find out what Ed's got.
Okay.
You can put him face up, Ed. It's all right. Ace, deuce, hearts against Tim's ace, nine of diamonds.
Nice call.
Neither of these players are that happy about this hand if you look at their body language. And we'll see what happens here on the flop.
The statistics show us that Tim's a 2-1 favorite, but of course there are some chops in here.
And the flop is good for Tim because anything that doesn't put the deuce in the hearts. Oh. And through all five cards, all right, Tim is the winner.
That's it.
And good game.
Ed Hahalik played great today. He really did. He had some struggles at the beginning and lost a couple of pots that he thought he was going to win on the early streets and got beat up pretty bad on the late streets, then worked that stack right back up, was our chip leader for a short time. Played great today. Ed Hahalik, 30 years old from Oak Forest, Illinois. He's going to go home in third place. He'll get a $350 qualifier seat. He'll be back in July. This is fantastic. Oh no, Mr. Bill! He'll be back in July for the qualifier to win a seat into the $3,000 summer main event for Windy City Poker Championship. A reminder that we are at Charter Fitness. I don't know why that just popped into my head, but it did. At Charter Fitness, Midlothian, Illinois.
147th and Cicero Avenue.
Thank you
kindly.
Oh,
and it looks like we're going to have a big pot right away. Both players getting dealt an ace on the first hand. Tim makes it 23,000, and Andrew puts 52 in.
And a quick call.
Tim laughs as he turns it over and sees that he's behind.
Didn't expect that one coming.
And this hand is pretty much the tournament right here, even if the short stack doubles up. they're going to have an awful lot of chips. No, I take that back. Tim will still have 87,000 in chips. Is that right?
Yeah, it'll be close. It'll be 113 to 87.
All right.
The flop gives Andrew the king.
Five.
Wow. Tim picks up the straight draw.
Five. Seven.
Oh. Five in the end would
and
do
he
it.
Dodges it. Can you see like the relief five. There?
Yeah. It looked like it.
And Andrew almost can't believe that the best hand held up. Started with the best hand, flopped to make it even better.
Nice hand, sir.
He has not had a whole lot of success when he's had his chips in ahead. He has had some success when he's had his chips in from behind.
Well, I can say when that six comes off the deck, it looks an awfully lot like a five when
Absolutely.
You're trying to dodge a five. Now, we may see all in again this hand.
Mm-hmm. Raise to 20.
And Tim just makes the call. He's hoping to see a favorable flop. King in the door.
Now
that an eight, that's a problem.
That eight could spell the end of it. He puts it all in, and now if Andrew makes the call, we could have ourselves a winner.
It's 41 a call. Andrew's getting almost 3-1 on his money.
41.
He's got a pocket pair that's got only one overcard on the board.
But if Tim has that overcard, Andrew's in really bad shape.
Absolutely.
This is a really good bet here by Tim. You're exactly right. Representing the king, hoping that Andrew can lay this down.
Or hoping that the eight was good enough, but now he knows he's probably rooting for a fold at this point.
But he puts in the call.
Andrew makes the call. Tim's going to need an ace or an eight or two running hearts.
Nice hand.
Tim taps the table as though he's already lost, although we all know that Tim's still going to win every fourth time.
Ooh.
And there it is right there.
Right on the turn. This is just...
And then the nine on the river. That was just
heartbreak,
and then heartbreak.
What an incredible finish.
Interesting.
What an incredible finish. The blinds had gotten high. The players didn't have too many choices left.
You got it in good.
I'm going to go down and talk to Zeus.
Thank you, Mom.
Talk to Andrew, who reigned over the table like the Greek god of gods.
This is Ben Ponzio with Joel Schaub for Windy City Poker. We're going to send it down to the championship table with Jason Finn interviewing our winner.
Well, I am sitting here with the winner of our single table World Series of Poker qualifier, and what an unbelievable finish. How do you feel? What was this tournament like for you today? Standard, regular old tournament?
Oh, my goodness. It was anything but standard. Obviously, classic poker roller coaster. A lot of really good players on the table, very measured players. No one got out of hand early. I was actually shocked we were playing level 9-10, we had no one out.
You had two or three times where you were in with the best of it, and you got drawn out on, but you didn't give up.
Yep, no, you can never give up in these situations. Just buckle down, keep going. I'm thankful, I'm shocked, this run out. I cannot get over this run out. That's normally how I lose without this one.
That's right.
It's exactly how normally goes. I am super pumped, super excited.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
You played great poker today. You beat Tim in the end, heads up, who also had a great day of poker. But you're going to be going to Las Vegas for the main event of the World Series of Poker. We wish you luck on behalf of everyone here, the crew at Windy City Poker Championship, Ben Ponzio, Joel Schaub, and everybody else. Thanks so much.
Don't worry, poker fans. There's more Windy City Poker Championship coming to you after the break. Jason Finn and Ben Ponzio return to bring you the action from our $3,000 July 2019 main event. Stay tuned.
This broadcast brought to you in high definition by the Little Guys Home Technology. More knowledge, more experience, better results. That's the Little Guys. 191st and LaGrange, just off I-80 in Mokena, or at thelittleguys.com.
It's the Windy City Poker Championship. Come on in it to win it.
Welcome to Windy City Poker Championship. I'm Jason Finn, here in the booth with Ben Ponzio. We're at Charter Fitness in Midlothian, Illinois, for the 2019 Windy City Poker Championship Summer Main Event. We have six players remaining at the table. $3,000 was the buy-in. And the next player eliminated is going to go home with $3,600 in cash and prizes. There's a total of $48,000 plus in the prize pool. And let's go right down to the felt to watch our final six players.
We're going to have some exciting action here. And these guys are competing for $48,000.
And we've got some great players at the table.
This is one of the most stacked final tables we've had at Windy City Poker in a long time.
We've got more than one Windy City Poker Championship champion at the table. We've got more than one Heartland Poker Tour champion
Raise
at the table, if I'm not mistaken.
1,200.
And just some Raise fierce 12, poker players
000.
Overall.
I mean 12,000. Excuse me.
I think this is the first time we've seen Wayne at a Windy City final table. Wayne Rooks.
Wayne comes in as our chip leader with over 300,000 in chips, and he opens with a raise. And Don calls him.
Check.
Raise 12,000.
Bet 12,000.
Wayne keeps the pressure on and is going to take the first pot of this final table.
Excellent. He takes it down. Those are probably our two least experienced players at the final table, both from a Windy City perspective and maybe from a poker tournament final table perspective. But both of these guys have chops, and they both had to navigate a tough field to get here today.
Fold?
I bet 14,000 one time chip.
Now we see Mike raising, Jack 10 suited.
No, you don't have to do that.
No, you don't do that.
It's not a one time. It's a.
It's
an extra 14,000.
Raise to 14,000.
Hey, Kirk, if we knock somebody out, do we get their time chips?
No, you don't.
Okay.
And if you saw the chip he moved out there, we do have what they call time chips. That's for the players. If they need extra time to deliberate, we've got a shot clock here where making decisions, you have 30 seconds to make them.
Ooh, and look at this. Mike flops second pair, and Craig flops bottom set.
And Mike's got a short stack and an aggressive style, but he's really good with card sense. So it'll be interesting to see how this hand plays out, because Craig's going to call and let Mike bet his chips.
Yeah, I totally agree on the card sense. He is one of the very best.
Now Craig's going to have to stab here because he doesn't want Mike to check again behind, and he just goes all in. Which is essentially putting Mike all in, and Mike has a decision to make. He's counting his chips. And the problem in this situation, Craig is also an aggressive player, and he could be doing this with a lot of things, including a nine that hit on the end, including nothing at all. We're looking at it. We know that if Mike makes the call, it's game over for him, but you know, and Mike has been a beast at these Windy City final tables. It'll be interesting to see. He generally will take a lot of time in some of these situations, and he's going to have to use his time cards to do that.
Well, it's interesting when he put in his bet earlier, he put the time card in, and he said, my time card. So I don't know if it was patently a joke or I don't know what he was quite trying to do, but he is struggling with this decision here. He flopped second pair. He bet and he got called. He checked through the turn, and he makes a great fold here.
Absolutely. But now Mike is left on a very short stack as well.
That's all she wrote.
Craig shows the three fives. Mike's comment, that's it.
Yeah. I don't think I'd ever give Mike any more information.
No, he is as dangerous as they come, although Craig is just as dangerous. Neither one is a guy you want to end up at a poker table with.
Totally.
They're both the nicest guys to play with, but they're going to take all your chips.
Absolutely. As you said, Mike has won. He's a beast at these tables. He's won three. He has a second place finish in Windy City Poker Championship. He's got at least one Heartland Poker Tour title. I know that because I happen to be in the booth for that victory.
Nearly 1.4 million in lifetime winnings.
Incredible.
Don just calling here with the ace-queen. Lloyd makes the fold, and Paul wakes up with aces. Don playing very conservative to start out. He folded the sevens. He's just calling here. And Paul's going to probably make a moderate raise because he doesn't want to scare off Don.
Chris?
Raise to 21.
Already makes it 21,000 to go.
Thanks.
Craig gets out of the way with his six deuce.
Wayne with the big stack making the call, though. It'll be interesting because if you're in Don's shoes, I was going to say you might even consider a re-raise here, even though knowing what Paul had, it'd be wrong.
And if it was a re-raise, it'd be for all those chips. Uh-oh, and that could be some trouble. Eight, jack, six.
And Wayne's going to lead out.
20,000.
Just 20,000, though. Small bet into this pot.
All in.
Paul announces all in, puts a stack of orange chips forward.
Paul only had 95,000 left to make this bet, so it's 75,000 more to Wayne, which in this pot size is kind of on the small side.
Has quickly ballooned to 184,000 in chips. Paul started the final table with 116,000 in chips.
Call.
Wow. Wayne makes the call.
Wow, he does make the call.
Now, Wayne's into martial arts, and he's going to need a queen or a jack to karate chop Paul out of this tournament. Otherwise, Paul is going to double up.
I'm so glad you said it and I didn't.
I can't always let you have the cheesy joke.
259,000 chips in this pot. Two cards to come. Wayne needs a queen or a jack, and he gets it immediately.
Wow.
Wow. And a 10 of clubs on the end. And just like that, Paul Fisher eliminated in sixth place.
Thank you.
Lloyd Mandel can't believe he jumped up a spot in the money. And Paul Fisher cannot believe he got his money in so good.
See you, Paul.
I knew. I told you that. This is going to be able to do.
From 36 to 4.
And now we are left with five players and just under $45,000 in this prize pool remaining.
And this makes Mike's and Lloyd's and Don's stacks a little more gamblable, because now we're down to five places, and each one of them has to jockey with the other, but at the same time has to figure out their spot. And Lloyd's going to take his chance here with the 9-7 suited.
Good luck.
Craig with just a queen. He's going to let it go, and it gets to Wayne. Wayne folds, and with Mike's stack, I don't think he can call this, but he does. Very similar hands, 8-6 of diamonds, 9-7 of clubs.
60-40 situation. Both players suited, both players play in the middle of that deck. And a 5-6 king.
So Mike makes the pair of sixes, while Lloyd picks up the straight draw.
He's a 7-8 or 9, he doesn't get it. A pair of sixes is going to be good enough, and just like that, two eliminations in a row. Lloyd Mandel will be leaving us in fifth place, and we'll be down to the final four players at this Windy City Poker Championship final table.
This portion of the show is brought to you by Rental Max in Orland Park, Illinois. Rental Max has a full line of Bobcats available. You can rent skid steers, excavators, and tree stump grinders. Look to Rental Max to help you out with all of your landscaping needs, including aerial rentals, boom lifts, and so much more. And of course, they have trucks available for your next major move or project. Call 708-535-5080 or search online for Rental Max Orland Park.
So Mike is going to retake his seat at the table. Needed a little bit of space. We got a 10-handed table here, but all four guys are in there pretty snug based on where our early busts went out and where our cameras are set up.
And what looked like it could be a quick night may actually turn out to be a much longer night now that two of the short stacks have decent chip stacks to play.
We've had lots of playable hands here. Craig's first to act.
King 10 suited. We'll probably see a raise out of him. And with Wayne right behind him, with the ace-queen offsuit, we may see a re-raise, too.
And if I'm Wayne, I'm saying to the dealer, I'm saying, Mo, quit giving me these good hands. I don't want them.
I'll go all in.
He's all in?
Player's all in.
And Don with the easiest decision at the table. Throw it away and hope Mike busts.
I think we'll see Craig fold, and then Wayne's just going to be cursing his lot. And this is the sort of hand you ask for when you're four-handed at the final table.
Good luck, Mike.
Craig getting 3-2 on a call, but he's got a player right behind him, a player that has him covered.
Be okay if they start moving the chips on this side of the table.
Don asks that the chips be moved towards his side of the table.
Table's a little lopsided right now.
There's 158,000 chips in the pot.
One more time, I'll call.
And a call.
I've got to win one of them.
Shows fives.
And Mike Hahn, a slight favorite you see there with the fives, a 53% favorite. As far as we know, all of Wayne's aces and queens are live. King, four, deuce. Nine of hearts, that eliminates the ace of hearts and the queen of hearts. And another five, and Mike makes a set.
That's the second set of fives that we've seen at this table already.
And Mike Hahn doubles up again. How many hands in are we? Yeah. 10 hands in?
Yeah, really, he did.
Okay. As I mentioned, Wayne Rooks from Gary, Indiana. He's not only a poker player, but he enjoys roller skating, Ben.
Now we look here. Wayne with the ace-queen again, and Mike with the queens.
Oh, my gosh. This is just incredible.
Mike just calls. I think we'll get a fold out of Don, and Craig could dance with this.
Absolutely, getting really good odds on a call with 200,000 plus chips in reserve.
Three players.
Five, Trey Deuce.
But two diamonds for Wayne to give him the nut diamond draw. We may see these two all in again.
16,000.
Wayne's got two over cards, a four flush, and a gut shot straight draw.
And Mike just calls.
You know, a lot of players are going to raise in that spot with the over pair. But we've seen Mike do this many times. He is such a good read.
And we get the king of diamonds. And Wayne checks his nut flush.
And then looks back at his cards to try to determine or to try to get Mike to believe that he doesn't know if he's got the flush or not.
Mike checks behind. So what's interesting here, a lot of times that looking back at your card says I have one diamond.
25,000.
So Mike's going to have to call here.
Did you see that little head shake that Wayne gave before he reached for his chips?
Yeah. Mike may be able to sniff this out. We've seen him sniff out a lot of hands.
Now, the bet was only 25,000. Mike's getting 4.5-1 on a call. And here's where that shot clock comes into play. He's got 5 seconds to act, or he can use his time bank. And he will do that.
And that's going to give him another 30 seconds. And he's going to make a raise. Now, if you're Wayne, you're really not scared of a lot. Because any king you're up against is probably not matched with a 2, 3, or 5.
All in.
And Wayne goes all in, and Mike just not happy.
We haven't seen Mike make very many missteps on the final tables here at Windy City Poker Championship. And he did believe that those queens were good when he put that bet in there. That was a value bet that went wrong.
Now you'll notice that the clock started at a minute and not 30 seconds. Against an all-in, a player gets a minute as opposed to 30 seconds. With the chip count, he will get a pause on his countdown clock while they figure out how much the actual bet is. By our guess, it's 204,000, which is more than Mike has. But it matters to Mike, too, to know in a situation like this, how much is Wayne risking? Is he risking his whole stack, or does he have enough chips where if he gets called and loses, it's not the end of the world?
That's a great point, Ben.
And a fold.
Yeah, Mike does make the right fold.
I'll see it on TV. Very nice.
Wayne said no need to wait.
I'll see it now.
Yeah.
We lost two players in the first orbit, and the chips have been flying back and forth here.
Yeah, there's been a lot of all-ins, a lot of action. Here Mike wakes up with an ace, moves all in, and Don's going to move all in right behind him with ace-jack, I assume.
And Mike only with 98,000 in chips, but he's got Don covered. Don started this hand with 62,000 in chips. I can't imagine a world where Don's going to fold here.
Look. Sorta.
Mike says good luck, sorta.
Half-hearted. Half-hearted well wishes. And this seems like a dire situation when you're the guy with the ace five, but Mike actually has 31% equity in this hand. He's got a straight draw. A five would be good, assuming Don doesn't make a jack. And of course, all kinds of boards can run out that give them both a chop.
10, 10, 9. Mike actually doesn't mind that because it gives him a lot of draws. Now a king or a nine will chop. But with the four, that's going to double up Don and leave Mike with only 30,000, which is 2.5 big blinds.
Mike is an excellent poker player, but when you have 2.5 big blinds, all you can do is pray to the poker gods.
This portion of the show is brought to you by Joel Schaub at Guaranteed Rate. His all-in pricing has a $350 flat lender fee that covers everything, including underwriting, processing, and appraisal for your property. Joel has thousands of very satisfied clients. So to purchase or refi for just $350 or talk to him directly, call 773-654-2049 or log on to guaranteedrate.com/Joel Schaub.
So Don's playing a style that will work in a 10-handed, 9-handed game, but as you get narrower, he's got to open his range.
Absolutely, and those blinds come around every other hand. You know, half the hands, you are committing chips to the pot, whether you're playing or not.
Call option.
Check.
Both players have a 7. This could
12,000.
Be problematic.
Mike, you're short, so you kind of have to make a decision up front. How far are you going to go with this hand? Because you can't afford to just call down a couple streets. Wayne picks up the straight draw. Oh, they both do. Actually, the straight would be the worst thing for Wayne.
Yep. And just gets a call out of Mike. Mike's got, I think, about 33,000 behind.
I think Mike's hoping for a check because I think he'd be happy to just check it back.
25,000.
And look at Mike's face.
He was really hoping for a check.
And Mike trying to decipher what's going on here, but the board has changed texture on every street.
Oh, I don't want to even look at it.
He's trying to decide. Often that shows a little bit of weakness as well. Wayne wasn't deterred by the 9 coming, which would have completed some straight draws. The 3 of spades coming on the end, which would have completed some flush draws.
And Mike makes the call, though.
Great, great call from Mike Hahn.
Just a 7?
Just a 7.
7
with a
10. 10 place. Oh, I tell you, you'd be squeaking back.
I had you notched. Notched barely.
Goodness.
That's a good call.
Craig on the button this time. Don Barnes first to act.
Now Craig wakes up with the big hand, American Airlines.
Let's hope this isn't the time that Don decides to open up his range.
Although we would like to see action back and forth. And it looks like we're not going to get any out of Wayne here. So the question is, what is Mike sitting on?
What are we at?
Oh.
Blinds just went up to 8 and 16. And so the minimum Craig can make it is 32.
And he opts for slightly more, 34.
And Mike has a pocket pair. And 200,000 in chips. He just makes the call. Relying on that excellent poker sense he has to say, let's see what happens when we see a flop. There's only one overcard to his sixes, which is about as good as you can hope for when you've got that sort of hand.
But it puts you in dangerous waters because Craig is going to bet, and what do?
26.
Mike doesn't know this, but one of the sixes has already been folded. So he's going to make the call. He's going to peel one off. King comes on the turn, he'll check. If Craig bets again, I'd expect to see him fold.
All in.
Craig shoves his whole stack in, but I have a feeling Mike will just let this go. Although every time I say that, Mike starts looking at his chips.
Now, Mike believes, I think, now believes that Craig started off with a good hand. And ace king and ace jack both beat him. Any pocket pair other than fives beats him. It's unlikely Craig would go crazy with a pair of fives here.
And Craig's going to move up over 250,000 chips.
We recently celebrated our 10-year anniversary, if I'm not mistaken, here at the Windy City Poker Championship. We've done a lot of these. We have given a lot of players around the Chicagoland area and those who have traveled from far away the opportunity to play some great poker, some excellent tournament structure, some fun cash games to play in front of a camera, to play on television.
And even the opportunity to play in the main event of the World Series of Poker.
That's right. We sent somebody there just last month in our tournament broadcast.
And what's cool about the way they do some of those is they have a player share concept. So if you play in the tournament, you have a chance, even if you don't win it, to get a piece of what that person wins if they go to the World Series. So, for example, if the player had won, I believe 25%, I don't know the percentage exactly, goes to the other players.
That's right.
So that $10 million prize, $2.5 million, would have been spread out among other Windy City Poker players. But Chicago's done well at the World Series of Poker. 2 years ago, the champion was from Evanston, Illinois. This year, we had a fifth-place finisher from Chicago.
Yep, yep, absolutely. And I think none of the nine guys who made the final table last year cashed this year. I think that's a statistic I heard. So that just tells you how hard it is, even if you're not only an experienced and an accomplished poker player, but one who's had a great deal of success at the main event specifically, how hard it is to get there. While I'm talking over Craig betting into Mike Hahn, who has flopped a piece of this.
But it's the smallest piece. And this is where Mike's reading ability is really impressive. But Craig does pick up the nut flush draw.
All in.
And he moves all in.
Wow.
Now with maximum pressure on Mike, Mike's in a bad spot because he could be way behind.
And we just saw Craig take this line a couple hands ago with aces. Does so this hand on the draw.
And Craig can hit a spade, an ace, or an eight if Mike calls.
That's 15 outs, or as the graphic shows you, 38% chance.
And that's not counting the odds that Mike folds. Which that's a big part of when you're making an all-in bet, is not only to get there if you get called, but how often you get your opponent to fold.
There you go, fold equity. And Mike has a full minute to make the decision because it is an all-in bet.
He looks like he's decided to fold and he's trying to talk himself into staying.
That's right. And Craig now over 300,000 in chips. Mike back on the super short stack, but of course that hasn't stopped him so far.
He definitely moves his chips well in those situations.
I'll take this opportunity to let our listeners and followers online, our watchers online, know that they can follow us on Twitter at Windy City Poker. You can follow me at Chicago Jason, and Ben, your Twitter handle?
At Ben Ponzio.
That's an easy one. B-E-N-P-O-N-Z-I-O. On Facebook at Windy City Poker Championship. And you can find our home online at WindyCityPokerChampionship.com and ChicagoPokerClub.net.
It looks like we have another hand developing between Mike and Craig.
And Don with the best hand again, but doesn't make it to the flop.
Now that 10 is going to give Craig the best hand. And
good luck,
he
guys.
Goes all in, essentially putting Mike all in because it didn't affect Craig. Mike's going to make the call here, even though he didn't hit. He knows with two overs, he really doesn't have a choice because he didn't have enough chips to make the fold.
Absolutely, yeah. He puts in 36,000, and now there's 168,000 in the pot. Needs a king or a jack. Doesn't get it.
Mike Hahn, who has put up more wins than anyone here at Windy City Poker. And although he's not going to be in the final winner circle, he has taken home $5,000 in cash and prizes.
And Don, mostly just waiting around for the big hands.
He's got a short stack. My guess is this whole thing goes in, judging from how he's done it before.
I'm all in.
It's a bad spot for Craig. Craig has an ace.
How much is that?
And I hate those type of hands because they don't play well. Because against a pair, you're a big underdog, and against an ace, you're always behind.
Absolutely.
So unless you have a player who's going to do it with 4-5 and 8-9, and even then, you don't feel good about it.
Yep. And Don has not shown any hands that weren't big starting hands. Craig knows Don's tight. Ah, he does make the call. And he's going to be in trouble. He is.
Nice hand.
He's a pretty big dog. Don's 71%.
Don't worry. The ace always gets there. When I get queens or kings, the ace always gets there.
Craig wins this hand. We will be heads up for the championship. If Don wins this hand, we will not. Oh, no. Now he is.
Yeah, I did.
Craig is drawing dead. Craig will be the very short stack.
Craig falls down to 81,000 chips.
Your health and fitness journey starts here. Real people, real results. Over 20 convenient Greater Chicagoland locations. Join online at charterfitness.com/joinonline.
Going to be first to act with the queen 10 offsuit and three-handed. This is a good raising hand, but he just makes the call.
Yeah, queen 10 much more compelling than queen 6, certainly.
Now Craig with the short stack is in an interesting spot because he can see the flop for free, but he can put maximum pressure, which he decides to.
And the blinds are 10 and 20, so Wayne put in 20 voluntarily.
But it'll cost him a third of his stack to call.
All yours, sir.
And Craig's back up to 200,000 of chips.
Seems to be ace of spade every time, too.
Yeah.
Goodness.
I don't give it back.
He's a double up away from the chip lead, that's for sure.
And at this point, any hand can be a double up. There's just the chip stacks relative to what's going on are too low. This is, again, a situation where if you're Don and you're on this king, you kind of got to make a move. And he just makes the call.
Now, Craig's got a king. If that was a king nine or better, I think it's going in here, but I think Craig's going to pitch this one away.
And with Wayne waking up behind him with the ace, I would not have done that. That is where I would have made a big bet. I would have made them make decisions.
Three clubs come on the flop, Craig. With the best club, Wayne also with a club.
And Don makes bottom pair and puts the big bet out. Puts all 130,000 out.
That's a good bet.
Craig looks like he wants to call it.
All in.
Craig goes all in behind him.
I'm going to need some help.
Maybe not.
And Don said he's going to need some help, doesn't realize that he's actually a 2-to-1 favorite. Yeah.
Craig thought the king would be good if he hit it, but that would give Don two pairs, so Craig needs a club. Six of diamonds does not help. Seven of diamonds does not help, and now Don is up to 330,000 in chips.
And Wayne, had he had decided to call both of them, would have just been crowned our champion. The nice thing about a situation like this, even though Don has a stack, he's been so tight. I guess I spoke too soon. I was going to say, you know, you have a chance of getting the bet through.
I got a lot of work.
And
I'm ahead right now.
Don is ahead, but you can see there's only a 10% spread between Craig's 45% equity in the spot and Don's leading Jack Trey.
Okay.
Craig risks elimination.
9, 10, that helps.
Two-way straight draw for Craig. Although that's all he can hit because the jack is going to put Don way ahead. So he needs a 7 or a queen here. Does not come, and Craig Cassino will be our third-place finisher.
Nice hand.
Taking home 7,000.
7,000 in cash and prizes.
Nice playing with you guys.
All righty, sir. See you next time.
Thank you.
Craig just misses a championship again here on the Windy City Poker Championship.
And now the two amateur players, the two least experienced players that started this final table, are about to go heads up for an $18,000 in cash and prizes for first place.
Wayne has regained his chip lead here heads up. Don continues to play cautiously. He's got a suited 10 this hand, but Wayne on the button is first to act pre-flop.
Raise it to 40.
40.
And the min raise seems to be the raise of choice heads up. Don's looking like he's debating it, but now I think it's going away. Now he decides to make the call.
He's gotten a little bit stickier here heads up. He likes his suited hand.
And that's a good flop for him. Although, with the ace in Wayne's hand, this could be a lot of action here.
This could be a very big hand.
30.
Don leads out with a four flush and a gut shot straight draw. And Wayne makes the call with top pair and the same gut shot straight draw.
That six doesn't change anything.
30.
He's going to get raised.
Raised to 75.
Wayne takes it from 30 to 75 once again. Don's going to make a call. He's got his fingers crossed for a heart or a five, which would give him a chop.
And the king of clubs doesn't change it at all, which means Wayne is the winner of the hand as long as he holds up.
Wayne is the winner of the hand.
Didn't get there.
All in and a fold.
I tried.
Don shows the missed flush. And Don with a pair of sixes. He may just choose to put it all in right here.
And so he does.
Players all in.
Now, if you're Wayne, you got too many chips to even mess around here. When we talked earlier, the middle hand, queen seven, that means half the hands in the deck are technically better than you. This happens to be one of them.
If they were face up, it certainly would have some temptation.
I'll call.
Call?
I'll call.
All right, there's
and Wayne says, I'm ready to be done with this.
Yeah.
If Wayne wins this hand, he will be our Windy City Poker Championship champion. And if Don wins this hand, they will once again be tied with 430,000 in chips apiece. Don needs to dodge a queen, a seven, or any sort of weird combination of cards.
Good luck, Wayne.
You too, sir.
And it's always amazing how hard and easy it is at the same time in these situations.
Both of these guys played their heads off all day for it to all come down to this. Eight, tray, deuce. Good looking flop for Don.
Oh, the seven.
Wow, now Don needs a six and only a six.
Alrighty.
And that's it. Wayne is our champion, Wayne Rooks.
Wow. Wayne leads the final table nearly from wire to wire, takes it down. I'm going to head over to the table and see if I can ask Wayne a couple of questions before we lose him for the night.
I just played two cards. Couldn't do it.
Unbelievable. You led almost wire to wire at the final table against a bunch of assassins. How are you feeling right now?
I'm feeling great. This is my first major championship win. And at Windy City.
Absolutely.
So this is fantastic.
Some talented folks, $18,000 in cash and prizes for first place. You beat Craig Cassino, you beat Mike Hahn, you beat Lloyd Mandel, you beat Paul Fisher, and in the end you beat Don Barnes.
And I see these guys on television all the time saying, boy, I wish I could make it there and play these guys, and here I am.
Now when you sat down at the final table, did you feel like this is anybody's game, I've got a lot of chips, I can win this thing, or what was your strategy?
Well, really, I wasn't nervous at all. I figured anybody could win, okay? I talk poker strategy with my brother a lot, and, you know, we come and play, and anytime we lose or win, we go home, we talk and say, well, hell, poker, anybody can win. It's just the skill set, and the other half is luck.
Half skill, half luck.
Yeah.
Wayne Rooks, our new champion here at Windy City Poker Championship. On behalf of all of the crew, on behalf of Ben Ponzio, I'm Jason Finn, and we'll see you next time.
This portion of the show is brought to you by Joel Schaub at Guaranteed Rate. His all-in pricing has a $350 flat lender fee that covers everything, including underwriting, processing, and appraisal for your property. Joel has thousands of very satisfied clients. So to purchase or refi for just $350 or talk to him directly, call 773-654-2049 or log on to GuaranteedRate.com/Joel Schaub.